चीफ मिनिस्टर ऑफ कर्नाटका श्री बी एस येदुरप्पा जी, यूनियन मिनिस्टर फॉर डिफेंस श्री राजनाथ सिंह जी, चीफ ऑफ डिफेंस स्टाफ जनरल बिपिन रावत जी, सेक्रेटरी डिफेंस प्रोडक्शन श्री राजकुमार जी, डिस्टिंग्विश्ड पार्टिसिपेंट्स एंड गेस्ट्स, आई एम डिलाइटेड टू बी हियर टुडे अमंग यू ऑल फॉर द वेलीडिक्ट्री सेरेमनी ऑफ द 13th एडिशन of Aero India and to witness the grand international aero show. The participation of defense ministers and senior defense officials from several nations and many business leaders from around the world has added a significant value to this event. I am sure that the delegates would have experienced the vibrant energy of a new India and witnessed our vast capabilities as well as many opportunities that our country offers in the defense and aerospace sectors. I am also sure that this event provided the participating nations and industries an ideal platform to exchange ideas and forge partnerships. Ladies and gentlemen, the past year has been a time of unprecedented hardships due to COVID-19. Its adverse impacts have been felt on all walks of life over the world. Despite the challenges posed by the pandemic, I am happy that Aero India 2021 has been organized successfully. It has been held without compromising its spirit while following the COVID appropriate norms. Here I want to praise the courage and bravery of the Indian Air Force and our pilots for displaying exemplary professionalism in protecting India's skies and strengthening the country's defense. Aero India 2021 has been an unprecedented success. I am told that high-level delegations from 43 countries and exhibitors from 530 companies have participated in the event. Many more across the world got associated with the event virtually, which is the world's first mega event of this kind to be held in the hybrid format. I have also been informed that 201 new business partnerships have been developed in the form of MOUs, agreements and collaborations among various nations and companies. Our Union Defense Minister and Karnataka Chief Minister and their teams deserve an enthusiastic ovation for their hard work. Also, the delegates, participants and business leaders who have traveled long distances and ensured the success of this event, they all deserved special appreciation. I have been told that a conclave of defense ministers of Indian Ocean region on the theme of enhanced peace, security and cooperation in the Indian Ocean was organized on the margins of Aero India 2021. It is a matter of great significance that as many as 28 IOR countries participated in it. India has always been an ardent advocate of universal peace and development. IOR is an important reason because of its rich natural resources and strategic location. We have floated the idea of Sagar, which stands for security and growth for all in the region, to promote cooperation in the Indian Ocean region. It is important in the IOR nations focus on fostering political, economic, cultural, and defense cooperation. We have always been ready to share our expertise and resources with all IOR nations for planning and coordination in humanitarian assistance and disaster relief. After the COVID-19 outbreak, under Operation Sagar 1, we reached out to our neighbors and assisted them with medical teams, medicines, as well as diagnostic kits, ventilators, masks, gloves and other medical supplies. In keeping with India's stated commitment to use its vaccine production and delivery capacity to help the entire humanity fight the COVID-19 pandemic, supplies under grant assistance to our friendly foreign nations have already begun. Ladies and gentlemen, the chiefs of the Air Staff Conclave was another highlight of this event. I am pleased to note that deliberations focusing on areas of mutual interest were very fruitful and would help in creating a peaceful world order. Startup Manthan, the annual event for defense startups, has also drawn significant attention. Innovations for Defense Excellence, that is IDEX, was launched in 2018 to encourage innovators, entrepreneurs, MSMEs, and startups to engage with the defense establishment and solve military challenges. Through this platform, many startups are developing new technologies and products for military use. This is helping us develop indigenous innovation and self-reliance in defense technologies. In the 29 innovation challenges issued by the Indian military and defense public sector undertakings, and from over 1,200 applications from startups, around 100 winners referred to as IDEX innovators have been selected so far. The father of our nation, Mahatma Gandhi, had planted the seeds of Swadeshi and self-reliance during our freedom struggle. Now we have renewed this pledge and are making determined efforts with Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan by giving a fresh impetus in this direction with strategic policy measures backed by time-bound actions. Our vision is to create a robust economy and infrastructure alongside developing competitive supply chains and integrate them globally. Ladies and gentlemen, the reforms initiated in India in the last 6 years offer unprecedented opportunities to investors and private companies in the defense and aerospace sectors. We have taken a number of policy initiatives aimed at placing India among the top nations in the defense sector with twin objectives of self-reliance and export promotion. Among measures aimed at transforming India into a major defense manufacturing hub are notification of a negative list of 101 items, reforms in defense procurement policies and procedures, liberalization of the industrial licensing requirements, increase of FDI in the defense sector up to 74% through the automatic route and 100% through the government route, simplifying and offering incentives to offset discharge, streamlining export authorization procedures and approving export of major indigenous weapons like the Akash missiles. I have also been informed that with consistent FDI reforms, the foreign investment in the defense and aerospace sectors has grown by 200% in the last 5 years. The government is focused on promoting the ease of doing business to encourage manufacturers to set up units in India. The defense sector has also been witnessing steady liberalization. Industrial licensing requirements have been eliminated for a number of items. The processes for industrial license and export authorizations have been simplified and made online. To facilitate establishment of defense industries and give impetus to the MSMEs, two defense corridors have been established in the states of Uttar Pradesh and Tamil Nadu. All these efforts are expected to unleash a huge potential of job creation in the country while taking India into the path of self-reliance in defense production. The tremendous growth of India's strength in aerospace in recent years may be fathomed from the development of the new indigenous light combat aircraft, that is Tejas. I am happy to note that Hindustan Aeronautics Limited has got the orders for 83 Tejas aircraft from Indian Air Force, valued at more than rupees 48,000 crore. I am also told that capacity of LCA production at HAL is being enhanced. Hero India 2021 is a living proof of India's ever-growing strength in the defense and aerospace sectors at the global level. The event has exhibited that the global confidence in India's capabilities is growing steadily. Today, India is not just a market, but is also a land of immense opportunities for the whole world, including in the defense sector. I am confident that the 13th edition of Aero India will contribute significantly towards strengthening India's self-reliance in the defense sector, as well as establishing India as a manufacturer for the whole world. I wish you all the best in your endeavors. Thank you. Jai Hind.
Please rise for the national anthem.